In the tumultuous landscape of cybersecurity, the year 2023 bore witness to an array of unprecedented attacks that shook industries and shattered trust. From the high-stakes realm of gaming to the core infrastructure of global corporations, no sector was spared from the relentless onslaught of cyber threats. Among the myriad of incidents that unfolded, one of the most startling narratives emerged from the heart of Las Vegas, where the iconic MGM Grand found itself ensnared in a sophisticated ransomware attack. The MGM Grand in Las Vegas is a massive resort with over 5,000 rooms, known for its luxurious accommodations, casino floor, and roaring lion habitat, drawing crowds from across the globe. However, the result ground to a halt when a sophisticated ransomware attack targeted MGM's infrastructure. The hackers gained access to the MGM system by simply calling the resort's help desk and requesting a reset of the credentials for an employee with elevated privileges. In a mere 10-minute phone call, they obtained the login credentials for this employee's account, granting them access to the entire backend of the MGM systems. The hackers meticulously mapped vulnerabilities and deployed encryption software, rendering critical systems unusable. As a result, slot machines froze, reservations vanished, and hotel keycards malfunctioned, sparking widespread disruption and panic. MGM's esteemed reputation for reliability and luxury took a blow due to a widespread media coverage of the security breach. Videos from within the MGM went viral on TikTok, sparking a flurry of conspiracy theories among millions of viewers. One prevailing theory implicates the ransomware group Scattered Spider in orchestrating the attack. While it's speculated that the FBI possesses information regarding the group's identities, no arrests have been made in connection to this incident. While MGM spared no effort in responding to the attack, the recovery process proved arduous and far from flawless. Decrypting data and restoring operations unfolded as a slow, painstakingly battle against the ever-present hacking group, all while financial losses mounted and guest trust plummeted. Unlike MGM, which grappled with a single data breach in 2023, T-Mobile confronted the challenge of enduring two successful attacks within the same year. T-Mobile, a leading mobile phone and internet service provider, boasts millions of customers across the United States. They pride themselves on reliable connectivity and data security. In 2023, T-Mobile encountered not one, but two separate data breaches. The first transpired in January, compromising information from 37 million postpaid and prepaid accounts. However, hackers had gained access to their systems as early as November 2022 and remained undetected until January 2023. Exploiting an API vulnerability, they acquired names, addresses, phone numbers, and some internal account details. APIs serve as a software facilitating communication between apps and services. Hackers increasingly target APIs as larger companies like T-Mobile transition to cloud technology. These attacks succeed due to many companies lacking processes to manage and secure their APIs. Often, they lack a complete inventory of their APIs, making it impossible to identify vulnerabilities. Even when issues are identified, security teams often lack the expertise to address them, leaving a vulnerability often overlooked, but critically important in API security. The second breach, occurring in April, affected a smaller number, approximately 836 customers. Here, attackers employed a phishing scheme to obtain employee credentials, compromising social security numbers, government IDs, and T-Mobile account pins. Both breaches inflicted significant damage. Stolen customer data fueled concerns regarding identity theft and fraud. Public trust in T-Mobile's security practices plummeted, resulting in lawsuits and financial losses. The company faced rigorous scrutiny from government regulators and security experts. Moreover, the nature of the second breach involving employee impersonation prompted deeper inquiries into internal security protocols. The company promptly notified affected customers, offered credit monitoring services, and implemented security enhancements. They cooperated with law enforcement investigations and endeavored to identify the perpetrators, though pinpointing a single hacker responsible for the two breaches in 2023 proved elusive. Notably, this incident marks T-Mobile's confirmation of 9 data breaches since 2018. This contrasts sharply with the attack on Rockstar Games, where the hacker was swiftly apprehended. Rockstar Games is a renowned video game developer and publisher, known for creating open-world, action-adventure games with mature themes and often satirical storylines. They're most famous for the Grand Theft Auto series. a controversial yet highly successful franchise featuring criminal activity in fictionalized cities. The sixth installment in the franchise, GTA 6, is perhaps the most anticipated game in recent years, having been developed for over a decade. Therefore, fans were shocked when demo footage of the unreleased game surfaced on the internet and began going viral. This development had negative implications as the incomplete game appeared less than impressive. The hackers meticulously curated a list of employees and gained access to Rockstar's main Slack channel through a third-party vendor where confidential information was shared. Subsequently, the hackers successfully infiltrated an employee account involved in game development, obtaining in-progress videos, source code, and other confidential files. Posting on the Slack channel, the hacker threatened to release the source code if Rockstar did not contact them on Telegram within 24 hours. The culprit, identified as 18-year-old Arion Cottage, a member of a hacking group Lapsus, orchestrated a social engineering scheme rather than relying on a typical vulnerability exploit. Despite the initial breach occurring in late 2022, subsequent attacks by Lapsus Group triggered widespread damage and completely disrupted Rockstar's teaser campaign for GTA 6. Over 90 confidential gameplay clips and development footage were leaked online, shattering the secrecy surrounding the game. Initially, fans were ecstatic, but concerns about potential spoilers quickly arose. Rockstar struggled to contain the leaks, facing pressure to maintain secrecy and manage fan expectations. The rest of Arion Cottage did not mark the end of the story. Cottage's age and diagnosis of autism posed obstacles to a traditional trial. Deemed unfit to stand trial, he faced an unusual scenario, reflecting the delicate balance between accountability and understanding of mental health concerns. Although the jury confirmed Cottage's involvement, he did not receive a prison sentence. Due to his mental state, he received a restricted hospital order, confining him indefinitely until his release is subject to a mental health tribunal approval. While Rockstar disappointed its fans due to the leaked footage appearing unpromising, Darkbeam, a digital risk protection firm, let down its customers by failing to protect their data. Darkbeam provides digital risk protection to companies and helps to identify and mitigate cyber threats. They also act as a threat intelligence provider, which gathers and analyzes cyber threats from forums, dark web marketplaces, and leaked credential sources, which are then compiled into their servers for future reference. However, in September of 2023, an unexpected blackout hit Darkbeam's fortress. A critical vulnerability exposed Darkbeam's own data store, containing 3.8 billion records of email addresses and passwords from previous breaches. According to security researcher Bob Diachenko, the main culprit was an unprotected Elasticsearch and Kibana interface, granting unauthorized access to the sensitive data. These tools, while helpful for managing large datasets, require proper security measures like password protection and access control to prevent unauthorized access. Reports suggest the vulnerability resulted from human error, possibly an employee forgetting to re-secure the interface after maintenance or misconfiguring access permissions. The leaked data included 16 collections organized by email address, totaling 239 million unique login credential combinations. It's crucial to emphasize that this data came from earlier breaches, so the material wasn't completely new. However, Darkbeam's centralized collection and lack of proper security compounded the risk by providing attackers with an easily accessible target list. Darkbeam quickly rectified the issue, protected the interface, and contacted all affected parties. However, there was significant damage to their credibility as users called into question the company's data security methods, resulting in legal battles still ongoing. While Darkbeam's exposed data highlighted the challenges of protecting sensitive information, password manager LastPass demonstrated the potential consequences of not safeguarding user credentials. LastPass, trusted by millions, recognized by experts, a reputable password manager that promises ironclad security, safeguarding millions of users' digital keys. Customers entrusted their logins to this seemingly impenetrable vault, believing their online identities were secured. However, a simple Google search for the LastPass hack brings into question the credibility of their claims. Similar to T-Mobile, LastPass has also faced multiple successful attacks in recent years. The LastPass saga took a turn when the company linked the initial August breach. This deeper investigation revealed a more intricate and concerning reality. The attacker, unsatisfied with the initial breach, exploited stolen data to target a vulnerability in the third-party media software on a DevOps engineer's home computer. This allowed them to implement keylogger malware, capturing the engineer's master password and gaining access to the corporate vault. But the breach did not end there. The stolen credentials unlocked encrypted data within the vault and even AWS backup, granting access to critical keys and resources. This wasn't a quick hack. For months, the attacker operated undetected, potentially exfiltrating vast amounts of customer data. The alarm finally sounded when AWS security alerts detected unusual activity linked to stolen cloud identity and access management roles. Initially, the investigation struggled to differentiate between legitimate and malicious activity due to the valid stolen credentials. As the extent of the breach became clear, people became increasingly anxious. The prospect of stolen identities and data from websites sparked fears of targeted phishing attacks and account takeovers. While passwords remained protected, the intrusion questioned the overall encryption strength and raised worries about LastPass's security standards. LastPass scrambled to respond, offering credit monitoring and guidance on password rotation. The company faced lawsuits, brand damage, and a significant exodus of customers seeking alternative password managers. As LastPass grappled with sophisticated data exfiltration, the Sony hack revealed hackers employing novel tactics, prompting companies to rethink their cybersecurity strategies. On September 28th, a ransom group known as Ransomed VC made a chilling announcement, claiming to have breached Sony's servers and gained access to confidential files. They declared their intention to sell the stolen data after failed negotiations with Sony. Despite this, Sony remained silent on the matter until a separate incident in October, where a data breach compromised the personal information of 6,800 current and former employees, along with the family members. The breach exploited a vulnerability in Progress Software's Move It platform, which Sony used for file transfers. Sony attributed this attack to a different hacking group called CLOP. Sensitive information from Sony was accessed through this vulnerability on May 28, 2023, but the breach went undetected until the 2nd of June. While the exact nature of compromised data remains unclear, this breach was not an isolated incident, as the same vulnerability in MoveIt has been exploited against numerous other organizations. MoveIt is a popular managed file transfer platform used for many organizations, including Sony, to securely exchange large files over various networks. MFT platforms offer features like encryption, access control, and audit trails to ensure data integrity and confidentiality during transfers. However, vulnerabilities in such platforms can create significant security risks if not addressed promptly. In May of 2023, Progress Software discovered a critical vulnerability in MoveIt that allowed unauthorized access to stored files, enabling attackers to download sensitive data, alter files, or disrupt operations. Sony responded by promptly addressing the vulnerability, taking the MoveIt platform offline and implementing a patch. However, the damage was already done, causing widespread panic on social media about the security of the PlayStation network. While the focus of the Sony hack was on the exposed sensitive employee data, the 23andMe breach went further, potentially compromising the genetic privacy of millions and raising ethical concerns about the collection and security of sensitive health information. 23andMe is a personal genomics and biotechnology company, primarily known for its direct consumer genetic testing services. Millions entrust their saliva samples, unlocking the secrets of their DNA in exchange for genetic ancestry reports and health predispositions. 23andMe prides itself on data security, ensuring customer privacy was a top priority. This all changed when a recent data breach at 23andMe sent shockwaves through the genetic testing industry. Hackers managed to exploit existing vulnerabilities, bypassing 23andMe's systems entirely, to compromise data from 6.9 million profiles. The attack involved stolen login credentials, a technique known as credential stuffing, where hackers reuse passwords exposed in other breaches to gain unauthorized access. Once inside user accounts, they leveraged the DNA relatives feature, designed for public sharing, to scrape additional information about other users. The exposed data included names, birth years, and ancestry details, but not the raw genetic data itself. While the full scope of the breach and the attacker's motivations remain unclear, the incident disproportionately impacted Ashkenazi Jews and Chinese users, leading to concerns about targeted attacks or biases in the collected data. Furthermore, the inclusions of celebrities in the leak, though potentially fabricated, underscores the potential for reputational damage and misuse of this sensitive information. Even though the hackers exploited the vulnerability with credential stuffing, 23andMe took the opportunity to highlight the role of user behavior in this breach, emphasizing the importance of strong, unique passwords and two-factor authentication to avoid credential stuffing attempts, essentially urging the user to come up with passwords that are not reused and more difficult to guess. This did not sit right with many security leaders, and the CISO of Panther Labs stated, "Placing blame on the end user for large-scale security incidents is never a good move." This incident also reignites discussions about the inherent risks of centralized data storage and scraping within social media-like features of platforms like 23andMe. Because the DNA relatives tool matches users with their relatives, hackers were able to view the personal information of both the account holder and their relatives by breaking into a single account, increasing the overall number of 23andMe victims. The 23andMe leak is a harsh reminder of the growing threats to privacy in the digital age. While the company encourages customers to improve their security practices, the event highlights the importance of robust platform security safeguards and strict data protection rules, particularly for sensitive genetic material. Unlike the 23andMe breach, where personal details were leaked, the OCTA attack focused on the employee credentials, potentially granting attackers access to internal systems and customer data. OCTA, a leading identity and access management provider, has secure tools for online authentication, safeguarding access for countless businesses and their employees. Millions relied on OCTA to ensure smooth and secure login experiences. However, a recent data breach to OCTA, impacting hundreds of customers, has traced its origin back to a seemingly mundane act. An employee logging into their personal Google account on a company-managed laptop. This seemingly harmless action exposed sensitive credentials, leading to attackers gaining access to customer support files and compromising the accounts of 5 clients. The employee's mistake lay in saving the credentials of a service account used within Okta's customer support system within their personal Google account. Hackers seized this opportunity, exploiting the exposed credentials to access and download files containing session tokens. These tokens, essentially digital keys, allowed them to hijack the legitimate Okta sessions of 5 unsuspecting customers. However, Okta's initial investigation into the suspicious activity proved ineffective. They overlooked crucial log events due to the attacker's methodology of directly navigating to files instead of accessing them through the support cases. This oversight delayed identifying the breach for 14 critical days. While the attackers responsible for this operation remain unknown, some logical connections point towards a potential suspect. We previously discussed the MGM attack where a hacker group successfully compromised Okta accounts. The similarity in targeting Okta accounts in both incidents suggests that the Scattered Spider hacking group could be responsible. But this remains speculative until further confirmation. This incident serves as a reminder of the far-reaching consequences of seemingly minor lapses in judgment. It also highlights the importance of robust security practices, not just within organizations, but also on personal devices used for work purposes. Strong password management and avoiding the storage of sensitive information in unauthorized locations are now an essential practice. Shifting from targeting stolen employee credentials in the Okta incident, attackers are now exploiting unpatched software like ESXi. ESXi, a popular Type 1 hypervisor, efficiently virtualizes servers by hosting multiple operating systems on a single physical machine. But recent vulnerabilities highlight the importance of keeping software updated. We know that software updates are the most annoying thing to ever exist, and they come at the most inconvenient times. But they are important if you want to make sure that your system stays secure. ESXi allows organizations to run multiple virtual machines on a single physical server. Unfortunately, thousands of these servers worldwide remain vulnerable to a known remote code execution bug identified back in February 2021. Hackers seized this opportunity, compromising servers across Europe and North America, with France, the US, Germany, Canada, and the UK being the most impacted. The ESXi args ransomware encrypts data on the compromised servers, demanding a ransom of 2.06 Bitcoin per victim. This triple extortion technique further adds pressure by threatening to notify customers of the data breach, potentially causing significant reputational and financial damage. It's unclear who is driving the ransomware campaign. French cloud computing firm OVH Cloud reversed its earlier findings, which suggested a link to the Nevada ransomware version. The scope of this attack is concerning, with estimates suggesting over 3,200 servers compromised already. This highlights the widespread neglect of basic security hygiene, with many organizations failing to apply available patches despite warnings issued 2 years ago. Cybersecurity agencies in the US and Europe are actively investigating the campaign, while VMware urges users to patch their systems immediately. For more insightful cybersecurity content just like this, subscribe to Gridware Cybersecurity, and check the links in the description for access to our website, LinkedIn, and other social media platforms. We'll see you next time.